गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। आई विल डिस्कस टुडे मेडिकल नेग्लिजेंस अंडर डिफरेंट लॉज, कैटेगरीज एंड टाइप्स ऑफ मेडिकल नेग्लिजेंस। दिस टॉपिक आई विल कवर इंट्रोडक्शन, मेडिकल नेग्लिजेंस अंडर डिफरेंट लॉज, categories of medical negligence, type of medical negligence. Introduction. Why there is a need to know medical negligence under different laws, different categories and types. Along with the time it is developed, medical negligence, the concept of medical negligence developed under different laws, civil law, criminal law, further in consumer law as well. So that we will discuss under this today in this topic. What exactly is medical negligence? Medical negligence can be defined as an act which occurred with the lack of reasonable care or willful negligence by the doctor in respect of all aspects, in all aspects regarding patient, from showing the confidential report of the patient to unknown person and history of some unknown person, to making diagnosis and examination without patient permission, and many more. So as such, the meaning or the definition of the medical negligence is developed as per the time, as per the case. But broadly, medical negligence is omission to do something which should not be, and commission to do something which should not be. Regarding medical negligence under different laws, as it is mentioned there, medical negligence under law of torts, under law of contract, law of crime, law of consumers. Let us take first medical negligence under law of torts. The definition of negligence as tort involves the following constituents. For example, legal duty to exercise due care, breach of duty, consequential damage. The definition of Winfield distinguishes tortious liability from other liability of professional. In tort, duty is owed to person in general. Duty is imposed by law. The unliquidated damages is awarded in tortious claim. Meaning thereby, under the law of torts, it is the Winfield who elaborate the concept of medical negligence. And three essential element prescribed to get the remedy, and says that this is a tortious liability, and the remedy is to get the damage if there is a breach of duty. This is the common law principle or concept regarding medical negligence under law of torts. Already we have discussed these three essentials when in the previous lecture, when we were discussing the essentials or ingredient of medical negligence. Medical negligence under law of tort, how it come under law of contract. Liability for negligence in contract, law of contract, depend on the express or implied terms agreed upon by the patient and the medical person. Consent for treatment on payment of fee on the part of patient can be treated as implied contract with the doctor who undertake treatment on acceptance of the fees, impliedly promise to exercise proper care and skill. The liability for negligence medical negligence under law of contract will be depend upon the breach of contract, whether it is an implied contract or express contract, and there is a liquidated damages. or breach of contract between the patient and between the doctor. In law tort, there is an unliquidated damages, and in law contract, it is a liquidated damages. In law contract, it is a contractual liability. In law tort, it's a tortious liability. Although law in both whether it is a law tort or is a law contract, duty is imposed on the doctor by law. In the law torts, it is by common law. Under law contract, it is a statutory law. Now, medical negligence under law of crime. The liability for negligence in criminal law depends on the amount and degree of negligence. An act does not make a person guilty unless the mind is guilty. In order to amount to criminal rashness or criminal negligence, one must find out that rashness has been of such a degree as amount to taking as hazard, knowing that the hazard of such a degree that injury was most likely to be occurs thereby. The criminality lies in running the risk or doing such an act with recklessness and indifference to the consequences. Thus, it is a recklessness that constitute mens rea in criminal negligence. Supreme Court or the judiciary held a number of the cases that for negligence to amount to an offense, the element of mens rea must be shown to exist because the jurisprudential concept differs in criminal and civil law. In civil law, there is no need to prove mens rea is there, but in criminal law, mens rea has to prove. And second, recklessness has to prove there. The most of the punishment imposed in criminal liability for medical negligence have no concept of unliquidated damages, like tortious liability, but this distinction was reduced in England first and in India after that. By giving power to the criminal court to pay compensation to the victim. Normally, there is no provision to pay the compensation in case of criminal liability. And in civil liability, there is a concept of giving compensation. But this decision was reduced by court in England and in India also. As per Section 357 of the CRPC 1973, empowers the criminal court to award the compensation to the victim by passing the judgment of the conviction. In the Hari Krishan case in 1988, the Supreme Court has directed all the criminal court to exercise the power of awarding compensation to the victim of offences, so that victim or their legal heirs should not rush to the civil court. Meaning thereby for medical negligence, now victim can go to the criminal court to get the compensation as well. If a patient want to get the compensation, normally they used to go in civil court, but after 1988, after the giving the direction by the Supreme Court to the all criminal courts, that compensation should be given to the victim when the conviction is proved, the judgment of the conviction is given. And now the medical negligence under the law of consumer, that is a new branch of law. In 1986, this consumer law introduced in India. Before that, the cases related to that but treating under the law of torts. Consumer law provides better protection and relief to the persons who have hired services for consideration when the services provided are found to be suffering from deficiency in any respect. According to Supreme Court, a determination about deficiency in medical services is to be made by applying the same test as is applied in an action for damage. For medical negligence, it is well settled by various decisions that the activity of providing medical assistance for payment carried on by private hospitals and member of the medical profession falls within the scope of expression service under section 2 sub clause 1 sub clause 0 of the Consumer Protection Act 1986. Although government doctors or government hospital also coming under this category, and in the event of any deficiency in performance of such services, the aggrieved party means patient, victim, consumer, can invoke the remedies provided before the consumer forum having jurisdiction. Here patient has to prove that he was consumer. Therefore, broadly there are two types of negligence. After discussing all this the medical negligence under different law, we can say broadly there are two type of negligence: criminal law, medical negligence in criminal law, and medical negligence in civil law. In civil medical negligence, tortious, contractual, or consumer law, the duty owes, there is a duty which is duty of care, which is owes on the doctor towards the patient, and due to breach of that duty, the patient received damages. Whether damages was caused due to the breach of that duty, the standard proof in civil medical negligence is balance of probability, that there is more than 50% certainty. While in criminal negligence, medical negligence, the negligent act is gross, ignorant, reckless, and disregarded to the life and safety of the patient. Here the standard of proof is beyond reasonable doubt. That is almost 100% certainty. Regarding the categories of medical negligence, moreover, we can prove a number of the cases. We can prove doctors negligence when he had a duty of care towards his patient, but he breached that duty and patient suffered injury due to the breach of that duty of care. We can see in number of cases or case laws the ways which the doctor actually do the negligence in their services, which can be categorized like failure to attend or to treat the patient, error in diagnosis, failure to take full medical history of the patient, errors in treatment, failure of advice and communication, and many more. Regarding failure to attend, we can understand what actually happened all these categories of medical negligence. So doctor can be held liable for failure to attend the patient in case of accident or emergency, because it is the primary duty of doctor to attend the patient in case of accident, but they should treat them with full level of competence. It could include the things that if a junior doctor or a recipient doctor failed to bring the patient to the doctor. Error in diagnosis, that occurs when the doctor fails to take full medical history of the patient, like they do not take into consideration of the history of tuberculosis, eye weaknesses, pregnancy, etc. Another type of negligence, that is error in treatment, it occurs when they write the prescription in illegible, which is not it is not in a position to read, illegible handwriting which cannot be read by patient, miscalculating the drug doses, giving injection on wrong place and wrong disease. These are included in the errors in treatment. In the case of failure of advice and communication, in the initial state, it will be negligence on the part of doctor if he or she advises their patient wrong, or there become a gap in communication between the doctor and patient, and wrong advice has been given, and in that case there was a delay in in the treatment. So these are the ways for the categories, some categories where the medical negligence of the doctor prove in number of the cases. There are many more, but I have taken some. Types of medical negligence. On the basis of the judicial pronouncement, following are the types of medical negligence which also occurs in medical profession: active negligence, passive negligence, collateral negligence, comparative negligence, concurrent negligence, continued negligence, criminal negligence, gross negligence, hazard negligence, willful negligence, reckless negligence, negligence per se. Let us take the first one, active negligence. Active negligence, this kind of negligence happens actually due to lack of proper training and knowledge. So this type of action from origin is wrong, like giving injection in wrong site. Passive negligence. Here we can say that this type of negligence occurs where, because there is no action or omission of an act. Like if a doctor gives injection without knowing the history of allergy. Collateral negligence. This type of negligence is slightly in favor of the doctors, because in this collateral negligence is also known as a contributory negligence. It is in favor of, slightly in favor of doctor, because in this type of negligence, the patient has not paid much attention to doctor's advice and has failed to follow his advice, and thus due to that, the injury has incurred to him, and so there is a contribution of patient in his injury, and this type of negligence is said to be contributory or collateral negligence. Comparative negligence. This type of negligence can be applied to more than one act or omission, like some mistake of giving wrong injection to a patient can be done by a single doctor, and same can be done by two doctors altogether. Concurrent negligence. This is a concurrent negligence or comparative negligence, almost similar. When there is a negligence occurred by two or more doctors. Continued negligence. This is the worst negligence, because in this type of negligence, doctor leaves their patient intentionally or else abandon them as they know they have done negligent act or omission. Means they intentionally leave the patient in a vegetative state. Criminal negligence. This is the type of negligence where the mens rea or the recklessness is involved. Hazardous negligence. This type of negligence is mainly done by those doctors who do not have much knowledge of their equipment and does not know it, and thus it will come to a time when they use unsterilized instrument which later goes to harm patient. Means they do not follow the procedure and even they do not know about it. Willful negligence. In this type of negligence, doctor intentionally or deliberately do such things that lead to a harm to the patient. Reckless negligence. This type of negligence is actually done by the doctors who are habitual of taking high risk in their operation or the treatment, and thus sometimes they themselves do the reckless things in the operation that leads to the harm of the patient. Negligence per se. This type of negligence is violation of any codified law, statute, rule. It shows that doctor did not worry about the rule breaking and they are negligent in the work. So this is all about types of negligence, as it has been seen in number of the cases where the patient suffered due to the silly mistake, silly ignorant of the doctors, and sometimes it is the intentional or the gross negligence. Ultimately, it is the patient who suffer. although medical negligence has been recognized in number of the laws, patient is free to take remedy under different laws. The new topic is the difference between medical negligence and medical malpractice. Whether is there any difference or not, that we will discuss in the next lecture.